Hello everyone, Iktis here, back again with another video. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to root the zSecurity employee CTF. Before we do that, I would like to add that only 24% of you are subscribed to me. So if you haven't already, please smash the subscribe button, it would mean a lot to me. Now, back to the video. This box is medium rated, so beginners may find this box a bit challenging. So without further ado, let's get started. I'm going to start off with a simple nmap scan to get all of the open ports on the machine. The command I'll be using is nmap-sv-a, and I'm going to paste the IP of the machine. So -sv will probe all of the open ports and -a will enable OS detection. Now let's run it. Now that we have the scan results, we can see that port 22 is open and port 80 is open. The one is running SSH and port 80 is running HTTP. So now let's try to access the website that is running on this machine. We can see this is an employee management service. And let's try to see if this website is responsive. And only the homepage is working over here. So let's just scroll a bit down and see what we can find. And here we can see something really interesting. We can see an email address. So it says this is oliver@employee-admin-ctf. And this really looks like a virtual host. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to add it to my etc hosts file. Now that we've done that, we can go back to our browser and try to access the virtual host. We can see right here that we get a completely different page, and it appears that this is a login page. So let's have a look at the source code of the page. We can see some comments which are not helpful in any sort of way. And the only helpful comment we can see right here is the human resource information system. So if we copy this and paste this on our browser, we get some sort of information about this service that is running. So now let's try to find this on exploit.db. And we can see right here, guys, that there is a remote code execution exploit for this CMS. As you can see, guys, this is a Python script. So I'm just going to download this and see if it works. I'm going to head to my downloads directory. And the file name was 49847. I'm going to execute it with Python 3. So the usage goes like this. We have to execute the program and then enter the target URL. So now I'm just going to copy this address and paste it right here. So it says there is an uploading cell. This cell uploads successfully and our cell is located right here. Now let's try to access it. Now, as you can see, guys, we have a PHP cell uploaded to the web server. Now, when I try to execute a command, we can see that we get the response. So now we have successfully got remote code execution to the server. Now, what's left for us to do in order to gain a more reliable connection is to download a reverse PHP cell to the server and then access it in order for us to gain full access to the server. I'm going to do just that. I'm going to locate the PHP reverse cell on my Kali machine. I'm going to copy that and paste it on my current directory. I'm going to rename the file to rev.php, and I'm going to edit it with nano. Now I need to get my IP address and paste it over here. And I'm gonna leave port 8888. So I'm going to save the file right here. I'm going to start my Python simple HTTP server. Now I'm going to head back to my cell and I'm going to do wget HTTP. I need to specify my IP address once again. I'm going to add port 8000 because I'm using port 8000 for the web server. I'm going to specify the file name, which is rev.php. And now the wget command will download this file to the web server. Now let's execute it. And we can see that we have a request here, a get request. So this means that the rev.php file has successfully been downloaded to the server. And if we do ls, we can see right here that we have the file downloaded. Now, all that's left for us to do is type out the name of the file, and before we access it, we need to start a netcat listener on port 8888. And once we access it, we gain the reverse connection. Now, I'm going to see if Python is installed on the server to initiate a Python PTY cell, and we can see that Python 3 is installed on the web server, and the command I'll be using is Python 3 dash c import PTY spawn pin bash, and now we get the Python PTY cell. I'm going to also export term equals xterm in order for me to be able to clear my screen properly. And now we have successfully got initial access to the server. Now, in order to win on this competition, you've got to root the machine. So now I'm going to find some root techniques in order to gain root access to this server. I'm going to find limpies on GitHub and clone the repository to my Kali machine. I'm going to copy the address. I'm going to open a new tab and I'm going to do git clone and paste the GitHub repository over here. Now we can see that this is right here. I can cd into this directory. I'm going to clear my screen. And we need limpies, so I'm gonna change my directory to limpies, and if I do ls once again, we can see the limpies.sh file. Now we need to run the Python simple HTTP server once again to get this file to the remote web server. So now I'm gonna do the same thing, python m simple HTTP server. I'm going to change my directory to tmp on the web server. And now I'm going to do wget HTTP. I need to specify my IP address once again. Specify port 8000 and add the name of the file, which is limpies.sh. We can see that the file is being downloaded. I'm going to clear my screen. And if I do ls, we can see limpies.sh over here. Now I'm going to change the permissions of the file with chmod. And I'm gonna do plus x to make this an executable. So chmod plus x limpies.sh. And now I'm gonna clear my screen once again to get full. And now I'm gonna clear my screen once again and run limpies.sh. And run limpies.sh. Let's see what we get. We can see right here that it says that dash has a critical privilege escalation vector. Well, we can see right here in the permissions that this file has an SUID, vulnerability. So now we can just wait for the scan to complete and then try to run Dash as a privileged user. And we'll see how that goes. Now that the scan is done, and with the information that we collected from this scan, we noticed that Dash has SUID, which means that we can easily privilege escalate to become root. Now, how are we supposed to do that? We just need to execute bin dash, but we need to specify the p parameter, and this will run the application on privilege mode. Now, after I do that, you can see on my ID result that we have the EUID as root, the EGID as root, and we are in groups root, which means that we can now go to root, and if I do ls, we can see the root flag over here. So that's it for today's video. I hope you learned something new today, and I'll see you guys on the next one.